Hey guys, this is David Kwan. So lately I've been writing a bunch of different stories, three stories, and I just want to talk about one story I've been working on. And writing a story is something that I really enjoy doing, although I haven't done it in recent times. But when I was a teenager, I used to write a lot. Like back when I was in junior high and in high school, I used to write quite a bit. There's some stories that I wrote that are like novel length. None of them good enough to actually, you know, be seen by anyone in the world. They're pretty horrible writing, but I mean, it's just saying that I actually used to write quite a bit. One story I was quite invested in, and that's probably my first novel length story I've written. And I wrote it, edited it, like rewrote it because a lot of the parts were horrible, re-edited it, and then I read it again like 2 years ago, and I found out the writing was too horrible to be salvaged, so I kind of just gave it up. And that whole rewriting process was quite painful. Like, I found out that, like, and it's true, writing a story once you have an idea, that's like the easiest part. The hardest part is reading what you've written and then like rewriting it. Because rewriting is necessary, especially when I was a junior high school student who really didn't know how to write that well. Yeah, that's been the most painful process. It even changed names. At first, it was called The Tempest, The Beginning of the End. And it's this whole crazy action story, because I was so inspired after playing Metal Gear Solid, so I wanted to write an action thriller story like that. So it's like there's a terrorist incident in Antarctica. I mean, it's a crazy story. It's the beginning of the end because near the end of that story, the sun gets blown up. So the whole world is in darkness. I know, it's a crazy bad story. Whatever. It was originally called The Tempest, The Beginning of the End. And I actually like went around. I remember going around junior high school, talking to my friends about it, and then like asking them to use their names to be characters in my story. those were the days, but it changed its name to As Long As You Fly, and then some of the, yeah, it's, man, those were the days. But anyway, that's my first novel-length story. Most of my stories were pretty long-winded, horribly written, and then I kind of gave it up after high school. I haven't written anything since, so it's been like, I'm starting to get back into the hang of writing, so it's been a really recent thing. And then going back to fiction writing from after having done all the college essays and journal articles and blogs, opinion pieces, it was like getting used to actually starting to write fiction again, which was the first thing I've written as, you know, that was like the first kind of writing that I've written. And then now going back to it, it feels like it was such a overwhelming kind of experience, but I'm getting back in the hang of it. And this is, currently I have three projects that I want to write out. And this is my home, the story. That's right now the one project that I've actually published some of on my blog site. I don't know if you would consider that publishing, but it's on there. It's viewable to the public. Anyone with internet access can read it. It's not very good, but it's something that I've written. So this is my home. It's a story about this guy, Emmanuel Sanchez, who lives in a homeless shelter, and that's hence the name. That's his home, which most people would not consider as their home. So here's this guy living in a homeless shelter. In the first part, there's three parts viewable to the public right now. I've published three parts so far, and I don't know how many more parts it's gonna have, but I'm imagining it's gonna, if I continue to write this story and flesh it out, it's gonna have a lot of parts. I'm planning, I don't know, 15, 20 different parts to it. But the first three parts are up. There isn't any plot developed yet. I've started writing the fourth part. I wrote about three pages, and it's starting to have plot. So that's interesting, because I've kind of imagined the story as, hey, here's this guy, here's this, each part is a day in his life. So I'm just like, it's really just going to be this guy living out his life in a homeless shelter and seeing what happens with that. But now it's actually starting to have some kind of story behind it, which is interesting because that was never my original intention. So there's this guy who lives in a homeless shelter, and then it's also an interesting idea for me because I personally worked at a homeless shelter. But I'm trying my best in this story to keep my actual experiences separate and totally not revealed, and this fiction world of Emmanuel Sanchez as just that, fictional. So I tried my best. Two of my characters that I'm going to write in here, they do have some personality traits that I noticed in a few of my coworkers, but they're too, like, the characters that I'm writing and the coworkers that I worked in the past are two totally different characters. Different names, different physical traits, different everything. It's just that, you know, some of the things that I was just like, oh, this would be really fun to put it in as this person kind of like OCD on like neatness, you know, and this person kind of like a drill sergeant to the clients, you know, like to the people who live in the shelter. There's a shelter worker who's like the rules by the book, everything, you know, and just kind of a little kind of just general traits that I just picked out. It has nothing to do with the real world experiences that I've had. Obviously, I'm doing that to, you know, because I don't think it's necessary and to protect myself. The shelter that I'm writing it, is very different from the shelter that I worked in. It's a different kind of shelter. I worked in a MICA population shelter, which is, you know, a shelter for mentally ill or chemically addicted. And this shelter is kind of, it's very different. It's a working shelter. So working man shelters and people who receive disabilities. So that's the kind of shelter that I'm writing the story about. So two different kind of shelters. Anyway, hold that, the whole realism aside thing, I do want to make it as, you know, realistic as possible in terms of what kind of shelter it is, what the shelter does, New York City shelter system, and all that. But it's not a documentary, it's not a nonfiction, it is fiction. And as I've said, I've started to develop a story behind it. The main, currently part four is, now there's the character, Emmanuel Sanchez, and then there's his best friend in the shelter who is Dawn. I haven't decided his last name yet, so his first name is Dawn, that's it. Dawn gets in trouble. And so that trouble is going to have them go through this whole conspiracy of them having to take on a gangster group in the shelter. So it's actually starting to have a story, which is interesting. But the deeper story I want to establish much further on, and it's going to contain a lot of parts, is the life, is Manuel's past. Because obviously he became homeless because he served a prison sentence for a rape charge, and he was convicted. He served 6 years in prison, and then right as he got out, I mean, there's, what else is, you lose six years of your life, and then he comes to a homeless shelter after that. So it's kind of goes, it's gonna go back into his past, because he has a daughter that he hasn't spoken to in ever, until the part two, which is why part two is like the most important day in his life. It's the first time in his life that he meets his 10-year-old daughter, who he refused to see since her birth. And so this whole story arc of him meeting who is now the mother of his daughter, because they had a relationship. Her past is pretty dark too, and his past is pretty dark. I haven't revealed yet their occupation, what their occupations were before before homeless shelter, before prison. And it's not a pretty life in the sense that it's not a conventional one. I haven't revealed that yet, but it's going to be revealed pretty soon. I'm not going to spoil my own story just yet on this video. But yeah, so that's kind of what I've been working on. And it's been an interesting writing process. I think the interesting about writing is I have this all planned out. Like, oh, this is going to be the name of this character. Here's just what it's going to be like. This is a scene when this character meets this character. This character is going to be like this character. I mean, all that. There's different scenes, different climatic moments, different plot points. And then I start writing it, and it's just like, let's change that. Let's change that whole thing. And so it has actually, like, become this whole different beast now. Because originally, I intended it to just be about the life of Manuel Sanchez. And part four, now I'm actually changing perspective in middle of the part four. So first part of the part four, as I told you guys, is about his best friend having a trouble and him helping out with this conspiracy deal. And then there's going to be a break, and it's going to actually go into the perspective of Emmanuel's daughter's mother, Rachel. Or not Rachel, Rochelle. And Rochelle is actually going to follow her life on that day. So it's kind of interesting how writing a story just kind of just goes everywhere. It's kind of unpredictable in a way, even though I, as a writer, planned it and, you know, wrote it like, this is how it's going to be. But now it's a different beast altogether. So it's been fun. That's kind of the story I've been writing on. Any questions or comments you have on that, feel free to ask me if I have any viewers in this video. And feel free to check out the story that I've been writing on my blog. Yeah.